My sister has the final say on advertising. You'll have to convince her.
I'd be glad to talk it over with her. Yes, I'd appreciate the opportunity.
Fine. Her schedule is pretty crowded and she wants to get back to Raleigh. How about dinner tonight at Dory's?
Dinner? Excellent. Oh, by the way, one of our men has just come back from Washington today. You know, conferences on administration policies. He may have some thoughts to contribute to the campaign. I'd like to bring him along with me, if I may. His name is Tom Verney.
It couldn't be, could it, that you think you'll need a little help with my sister?
No. I'm sure your sister and I will get along splendidly. It's just that Mr. Verney is one of the most brilliant minds in advertising, and we may as well have the benefit of his ideas.
Suit yourself. She may fall for him at that. How about 8 o'clock?
Good, good. You want my address?
What for? We'll meet you at Dory's.
Oh, all right. At Dory's at 8. Goodbye.
I didn't know you thought so well of me.
This is an emergency. Caldwell seems willing to give us the account, but now we have to sell his sister.
We?
You'll have to help. I'll give you some ideas to hand on to her, but if she's the silly old hag I think she is, all you'll have to do is turn on that charm and get her signature while she's high.
I must be a world beater. As easy as that.
Oh, don't be so modest. You know you're attractive to women.
All women?
Just those with the mother instinct.
Look here, young man. If you're in trouble, you'll have to plead your own case. We're in a hurry, and I want my breakfast.
I'd have been better off in jail at that. I got married instead.
Marcia!
Darling, we can hardly expect to keep it a secret. It'll be in all the papers.
Well, congratulations.
What?
And to you too, sir.
I'm her grandfather, not her groom.
Now, wait a minute. Mr. Darvack is a very good friend of Senator Caswell's.
The senator arranged a government subsidy for one of my railroads.
I see.
So you're off on your honeymoon?
Oh, hardly. My husband died.
He did? When?
Last night. We're planning his funeral. Aren't we, Gramps?
We're trying mighty hard.
Oh. Seem to get any lowdown on your late husband.
Oh, Mr. Rugel was most retiring. Actually, he lived the life of a hermit.
Hermit? However, did you meet?
Through his dog.
Dog?
Yes, he was... The dog wasn't a hermit, you see. He was. It was really very romantic.
Is this a private wake, or can anyone join?
Pete Webb.
And what are you doing here?
How dare you joke at a time like this?
Oh, forgive the intrusion, fair lady, but I bring tidings of great joy. What? No welcome kiss? Oh, hello, Valerie. I'll melt the frost from that smile when you hear my news. Marcia, I've never liked you in black.
I know. Only in black and blue.
Oh, I never laid a hand on her except in self-defense.
Do sit down, Mrs. Jeffers.
No,
heavy, thank you.
Oh, does your doctor really believe in exercise?
I imagine so. He rides in the park every morning. Do sit down.
Oh, you sit down.
Oh, no, yes, you
seem quite right. I'm the hostess.
Oh,
you're
yes,
the guest.
Yes, and you should have your feet up, please.
Should I? Mm-hmm. Why?
You know, all women...
Oh, darling, wouldn't you like a cocktail?
Oh, I'd love one.
You shouldn't drink now.
No.
Oh,
Tice, you know I'm dreadful at games. What's the answer? You tell me.
Darling, look. There's Ruth. Come on, let's say hello to her. Hello, Ruth! Good old Ruthie. Well, for heaven's sake, I didn't expect to see you here. Look at her. Doesn't she look well, darling? Say hello to Ruthie.
Hello.
What are you saying, darling?
I was just telling Mr. Diestro that we grow all our own vegetables here.
Oh.
Can you eat everything, Mrs. Collins?
Papa, I didn't say anything, but when I had my...
Oh, Mrs. Diestro, what do you think of Notre Dame's chances of playing in the Rose Bowl?
Well, Charlotte, I'm so glad you brought that up. I think they've got a great chance.
I'm sick of hearing people say they're in a slump.
So am I. I think it's downright defamation of character.
Darling, I don't think women are so interested in football.
Oh, yes. Yes, I am. If Notre Dame doesn't play in the Rose Bowl, I think I'll die.
Senor, did you notice on the blueprint my new plan for sluicing?
Oh, he has a wonderful idea.
Yes, we're all hopped up about it down at the office.
Sluicing, dear?
Yes, darling. Sluicing is a term applied in placer mining, where the gravel is carried to the head of the sluice by shoveling in wheelbarrows, by drag line excavators,
or by small steam shovels.
I'm afraid that's not much better, darling.
Let's get back to football.
Did you go to the fair, Mrs. D'Estro?
Oh, yes. How did you like the world of tomorrow? Oh, I am old-fashioned. I like the wonderful baby show. All of them in the little incubators. I like them, too.
You should. Now, senor, I've got the most wonderful surprise for you.
You have?
Mm.
What is it?
Yes, let us in on it.
Well, you know, on the blueprints for the new conveyors, we were using 30-weight oil for the rollers. Well, I figured out a plan to do the same thing with a 20-weight oil.
Darling, I'm so happy for you.
Oh, I did not know that.
You, didn't know what, Senora?
That your wife is a writer.
Oh, she's not a professional writer. But in her spare time, she writes articles for the Insurance Monthly. You see, we statisticians pick up a great deal of information that should be passed on to other women.
Well, if the plan...
A toast! To South America. And to our very charming guests, Senora and Senor D'Estro.
Senor?
Thank you. Now, you were saying?
Oh, yes, the article. It's based on a practical solution to the marriage problem.
The beautiful part of the plan is that it's being applied.
A toast to the United States. And may our two great countries always remain as close in friendship as our glasses.
Well, that was beautiful, Harry.
You see, Mrs. D'Estro, Ed has a little...
A toast to
both Americas!
Bravo.
Well, Anne's theory is that love...
Oh, beautiful for spacious skies,
for amber waves of grain, for purple mountain majesty above the fruited plain.
America, America, God shed his grace on thee
and command thy good with brotherhood.
Reverend Mother, I can't do it. I just know I can't.
I must insist. There are no two ways about it, sister. I do it myself, but I have a meeting with Father Devlin and have no idea what time I'll be free.
Reverend Mother, please.
Besides, the outing will do you good.
But Reverend Mother, I don't know anything about binders.
Braziers, sister. Braziers. This one, 2 dozen.
Aww.
Did Sister Ursula give you permission to leave the building?
Yes.
Yes, what?
Yes, Reverend Mother.
What?
Have a good trip. I'll pray for you.
And I'll pray for you. Somebody better.
Oh, it's groovy.
Roosevelt, Marble Land, the bomb worked great. Hey, Roosevelt, don't you want your money?
Reverend Mother,
Would you give this money to Rosabelle and Marvel Ann?
No, you give it to Father Chase to replace the broken window.
But they deserve it.
Don't you worry. I'll give them what they deserve.
You mean we're supposed to wash the whole bus, Reverend Mother?
From bumper to bumper.
But it's such a big bus, Reverend Mother.
Yes, isn't it? How did you miss out on this caper, sister?